Hi everybody, it's Kat Kirby here with this really sweet little fun tiny book that is made from one sheet of paper and one different paper for the cover. And when you open it out, it's just this really sweet long accordion book. And it has two sides. One side's blank and one side has the pattern of whatever paper you've used. I used thinner scrapbook paper for inside and a thicker scrapbook paper for the outside. And I love this paper. It's by an artist I follow. She goes by Crafty Chica. And you can find her papers and all kinds of other art supplies online. So I added a piece of sari ribbon to just create a closure. It's an option that you may or may not want to do. This book does tend to want to open, so I like to keep it able to be closed. And then once you make this book, you can use it for all kinds of things. I can imagine like having maybe words of inspiration or a poem or a favorite song lyrics or a story. And so this is what we'll be making today, okay? And what you'll need is a square piece of paper. This one happens to be 12 by 12, and that is what I used for this book. And if you use a piece of paper that's 12 by 12, you'll end up with a book that's 3 by 3. So whatever size whatever size you want your book to be, you need to multiply it by 4, and that'll be the size of paper. Allie made one that was 2 by 2. It was so cute and tiny. But really, with 12 by 12 being the biggest paper that's readily available, I think this is the right size to make. 8 by 8 is another size, any size that you want to cut your paper down with, too. And then bone folder and either scissors or an Ulfa knife or X-Acto blade and a ruler. If you want to tear your paper, I like to use a metal ruler. But if you're going to cut and if you don't want to use an X-Acto, you can just draw your lines with pencil and then cut them out that way. And then a glue stick, because there are 3 areas we will glue plus the 2 covers. So you'll need a glue stick or double-sided tape. And let's get started. There are very simple folds to get it started. The important thing is to really give it a good crease. So to begin with, we're going to just fold it in half one way, lining up the 2 edges, pressing down in the middle, and then flattening out your paper. And if I do it this way, that's better. Yep, that's better. Okay. And then you're going to open that up and fold one edge into the center. You're going to do this to both edges, right up into the middle, or just before you get to that middle. And again, start in the middle and press out with your bone folder. So you have a valley and a valley. And you're going to turn this around and do the same on this side so that you have 3 valleys, 3 valley folds, which when you look at the other side, they are mountain folds. Let's see if you can see it this way. No. So they stick up on one side and there are valleys on this side. And then you're going to do the same on the other side. So you're going to then take your paper and fold it in half the other way. So these are both hamburger folds because this is a square. If it was a rectangle, one of them would be, well, you know, a hot dog fold. Because if you've ever taught elementary school kids, I used to teach art K through 5, this is how we fold paper, hot dog or hamburger, and open it out. And at this point, you should have 8 rectangles. You can see them like that. And now we're going to fold this into the middle. Give it a nice sharp crease. Turn it around and do the same on the other half. Bring it to the middle, fold it, and then give it a sharp crease. And now you should have 16 little squares, and each square is 3 by 3 if you want to measure it. Okay. If you want this side to be, well, it doesn't really matter, because when you open your book, you'll see that it's either the pattern side or it's the blank side. So you can't be wrong, as I say with everything that we do here in this class. Whatever you do will be fine one way or the other. So now we have this big piece of paper with 16 squares, and what we're going to be doing is making 3 cuts. And the cuts are going to alternate, starting on this side, starting on this side, and starting on this side. So to make it easier today, I'm going to draw the lines where we're going to cut, but you don't have to. This is just to so you can see what I'm talking about. And I'm just going to use the ruler to make sure I'm in the right place. So this side, you're going to cut all the way down until you reach the beginning of that last square. And you're going to do that on both sides, like the first line that comes in from the sides. You're going to cut those the same way from the top down to that last intersection. Okay, so you're going to cut from the top of both of these down to where you're going to leave 1 square. And then the other line, the other cut, is going to come up from the bottom. So you have 2 from the top and then 1 from the bottom. And this one is going to go to the top, the last intersection at the top. Right here, you're going to cut this one, you're going to cut to here, this one you're going to cut to here, and this one you're going to do the same as that first one. So I'm going to take my big scissors. These are kitchen scissors. They are made by KAI. They're made in Japan. They're really good scissors. My brother sent these to me because I was at his house and he got some scissors out to do something in the kitchen. And he said, try these. And then, of course, I said, oh, my God, they're so good. So he bought me this pair. But you can get these on Amazon. I highly recommend. They're kitchen scissors. So I'm going to start here and cut this line all the way up to the top where I stop before I go all the way. So I'm going to stop just before that last square. And then I'm going to turn it because I like to do this in order. And I'm going to cut starting down here all the way up. Just before that last square. And then the last cut is the same as the first one. And I am definitely going to have to do something about this camera because I'm seeing one thing and you're seeing a different thing. Anyway, so now you should have like a giant letter M or W. So Allie called these legs, two pairs of legs on each side. And at this point, you are done cutting. So thankfully, that is all the cutting you need to do. And starting from one of these legs, we're going to, I'll turn it sideways so you can see. We're going to fold this over. So just take that first square and fold it over. And then we're going to fold it under. And with each fold, just give that a nice sharp crease. And then we're going to fold it over again. But then if we were to fold it over again, we would trap all the pages that we just folded. So rather than fold it over, we're going to fold it under at this turn. So then we have another straight line to go across. Let me just do that again. This is where I got stuck the first few times I made one of these. So we've come down this row, folded it, and then we get to this corner. We're going to take this bundle here and tuck it under so that it's still facing, so that it's now going to face this way. And then we can continue with our back and forth fold. So over, under, crease, over, crease. So we've already done two rows. Okay. What am I going to do now? If I go this way, what happens? Everything gets folded inside. We don't want that, so we're going to go under right there. And then over. Oops. Now you're starting to get a lot of pages in your little book. Under. Over. And the final row. You know what to do. Fold it under. Crease. You can use your bone folder. And then over. Under. And over. And that is the very basic part of this book. And if you open it out, you'll see it's a big accordion. But if you'll notice, you go valley fold, mountain fold, valley fold, and then some kind of weird fold, right? That's the corner that you turned, and then valley, mountain, valley, something weird. And then mountain, valley, and then weird. And those weird three things, this, this, and this, the ones that don't look like the rest of it, these are the ones we're going to glue, and the rest we're not going to glue. Okay, so get something to put under where you're going to glue. I like to use deli paper, but any paper will do. And again, the easiest way to find these is to open out your book and you'll see that something looks different. And the first one that looks different is this one. So I'm going to just fold it down. I'm going to glue it here using my handy dandy GLOO glue that I get from Jet Pens or Amazon, but it is my favorite glue. My second favorite is Yoohoo or Oohoo. Now I'm going to fold this over and press it. Okay. And I'm going to close it up again and open it up the long way. And now this has become, it's still weird, but it's now a page of its own. It adds an extra page in here. So you have you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pages there. I'm going to squish those together. This is my second corner fold. So I'm going to close it up until I get to that one. There we are. And just glue one side. Close that up. Give it a good press. I think I can get closer now that we're working small. And then last time, we're going to open it out. And now we have 1 and 2 of these solid pieces now. And then we have one more, right? And so we're going to get to that place and open it, glue it. The thing I like about glue, G-L-O-O, is that they're color coordinated to tell you what sort of glue they are. And the yellowish, goldish one is the least wrinkly one. I mean, obviously, with a glue stick, there's going to be possibly some wrinkling. But the gold one is the least wrinkly. There's a blue one that goes on blue and dries clear. And then there's a just a white one, which is just the clear. Okay, so let's get this out of the way and see what we have here. Okay, just open it out. Those gluey parts might want to stick a little bit. So now's the time to unstick them. There is one. And come on, where are you? There's one. There. Okay, so it should look like something like that, where you have just a plain fold, a fold with a thingy in it, another plain fold, a thing, a double glued thing, a plain glued, plain. And then that is your book. Okay, so to make the cover, let me spotlight that. To make the cover, and I've already done this without recording it, so you can see what it looks like, but I'm going to cut 2 pieces of this cardstock. It's a scrapbook paper cardstock. I need 2 pieces that are 3 inches by 3 inches. And for that, I like to use my grid mat and a ruler and an X-Acto blade. So I'm just going to cut 3 in here. It already started there, so we'll just complete that line of 3 inches. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I'll just cut it down to there, if I can remember how to count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, just down to there. And just do this one 6. Okay. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm very challenged with math and with numbers. And so this mat really helps me count. These are little marks for 1/4 inches, 1/2 inches. It's really good for my needs. Oops, missed a little bit there. Okay. And then I just need to cut this little guy in half at 3 inches. Okay. And that will become your 2 covers. So pretend this is the front cover. You'll just glue that on here and make sure that you press it with your bone folder really well. I learned that from Seth Apter, who said that pressure and friction, heat, really helps the glue to really stick down. And then for your back cover, you'll do the same. Pretend that's your back cover. You'll do the very same. And then you'll end up with something that looks like this. Okay. And then you can add a ribbon if you want to. And that, my friends, is how to make a snake book, because it looks like a snake slithering along the ground here. Just keep it open for a while, because that the glue that you use to close up these sections are going to stick to the papers. So keep it open until it's dry, and have a good day.